The black-eyed bastard knew that when my blade stilled the Empress's heart and delivered her daughter to the Lord Regent's men, everything would fall to pieces. He watched me do it anyway. And now the world's gone mad. Plague grinds the city down. Corruption rots. A mad killer roams the streets by night, seeking revenge. The overseers have stormed my hideout in the flooded district. And I'm in a strange duel with a mad witch named Delilah for the fate of the Empire. I'd say I was being punished, but I know that the world doesn't punish wicked people. We make our choices and take what comes. And the rest is void. I can't say I wasn't warned. The men are recovering well from the attack, but they don't understand the danger they're in. My mother warned me never to make an enemy of a witch. Corvo, here to settle our debt. You understand, I won't make this easy for you.
Thomas has returned with the information you requested. He's waiting for you below. Taking prisoners is exactly the sort of thing I'm talking about.
You don't have to remind me. It's Billy's doing that the overseer...
I found Lizzie Stride. Getting her to lend us her boat will be a bit complicated, however. She's in Coldridge. From what I hear, they've got enough on her to hold her for about 1,000 years.
Coldridge. We can use this. We'll get her out. And Stride will have to pay back the favor. We'll have our transport.
Ready to leave, sir? Or should I wait?
Delilah doesn't leave Brigmore Manor anymore. She doesn't have to. Which means I have to come to her. The manor's upriver, far out past the quarantine line. I'll need a ship. I've lived in Dunwall's underworld a long time. I know the players. Gang leaders. Madams. corrupt officials. But what I need is a smuggler who knows the river, someone I can trust. It's a reflection of Dunwall, or perhaps myself, that after all these years, the best choice I have is Lizzie Stride. And Lizzie Stride is in jail. This should get me in the front door at least. Looks like I'll need to check in with those guards by the gate.
Overseer. About time, Overseer. We sent for you hours ago.
There was a problem with the...
Guard, open the gate.
This mask won't fool an arc pylon.
What's wrong with me? We're sending three firing squad. No one...
Right through there.
What happened here?
Stupid goddamn.
Wrapped in? Good. Doesn't look like much, does she? Comfortable?
Yeah, it's nice.
All right, we'll get this done. Let's start with how you got into Dunwall Tower in the first place.
Getting sick.
Was it one of the servants that let you in? Was one of the guards?
Slag Jaw and his Bottle Street boys jumping. See the problem?
Don't look at me. I don't know anything about what happened. Paid off a guard to give him a key. So now we've got the tumbler system.
So I have to remember a number and walk all the way back here just to unlock a cell? Because they paid off a guard?
This disguise won't help me if I'm caught in a restricted wing. This controls all the cell doors.
Someone else.
Harold. He's not in the cell.
Check the log. We've been moving people around to make room for the politicals.
This never happened under the Empress.
Someone will hear you. And it wasn't easy with the Empress around. She'd hold inspections with the Royal Protector trailer after.
Yeah, nice.
I wish we'd taken care of him. He He knows our faces. He could come back any time. Cell A14's been telling stories again.
What was it this time?
Claims he overheard one of the others talking, planning an escape. Started shouting for the guards.
He'll report anyone for an extra half ration.
Dereliction of duty and the reasonable suspicion of treasonous conspiracy. I hereby sentence you to death. Ready. Take aim. Fire! Private Morris, you refused to pursue Corvo into the sewer complex on the day of his escape. You displayed cowardice in the face of a national crisis. And I hereby sentence you to death. Ready. Take aim. Fire! Watch, Officer Thorpe. You provide...
I'll find you, you hagfish.
not dead. See that her wounds get attention.
It will be done. All quiet, sir. Ready to go.
Let's go. Dunwall is changing fast. 6 months ago, Draper's Ward was where Dunwall's rich and well-born strolled and shopped and tried to be seen. The plague burned through it in days. Today it's a battleground where two street gangs fight over the spoils. The Hatters and Lizzie's gang, the Dead Eels. Lizzie Stride was the boss until Edgar Wakefield betrayed her and took her place. And the riverboat. It's the kind of thing that happens every day in Dunwall. I don't judge him. I've done worse myself. But I need that boat. Edgar Wakefield and I have business.
The textile mill used to run off a water wheel before the canal went dry. It started up again recently, and whatever the Hatters did to get it working has enraged the Dead Eels. They're fighting in the streets.
Why don't you come out and dance a river shimmy with me? I can smell.
Thank you.
Just make it quick. If you're here to kill me, make it fast or get lost. I thought I was finished. They'll never believe who saved me.
Draper's Ward Salvage and Resale, or the Black Market if you'd prefer. It's Dowd, right? Recognized your face from the posters. Not that I'd ever say anything to anyone, believe me. I'd be happy to have you for a customer.
What are you selling?
The best of Draper's Ward, all for sale. City's dead. We won't make it 3 more months. Delilah, are you with her? No, but you don't have any roses.
What can you tell me about Delilah?
I used to make clothing for the Caldwins, you see. I adored them, especially young, precocious Emily. She was such a delight. Did you ever meet the Empress? She was so special. And I was able to count her among my friends. I had a lock of hair from young Emily, a keepsake given to me by the family when my hands grew too stiff and clumsy to work the needle. I have treasured it so.
And Delilah?
She visited me here. Such a surprise to see her, all grown up, so serious. Did you know she was once a playmate of Jessamine's? Before she was Empress, when they were both little. I thought it was a cordial visit at first, but it turned frightening.
What happened?
She made things come out of the shadows, long and grasping. I can still feel the cold on my neck. I sound mad, don't I? Perhaps I am. She questioned me and left me propped in the corner like a bolt of cloth. I couldn't move for 3 nights while she made the horrid markings you see now. Then she stole my only keepsake, my lock of hair from dear, sweet Emily. Ah, Emily, where are you? Damn that Corvo, and damn Delilah. All these rats crawling all over everything.
these rats crawling all over everything.
Emily, she was such a sweet girl.
Wakefield is on board the Undine. He's put all of the Eels on alert since Lizzie's rumored to have escaped from Coldridge. He's expecting her. It will undoubtedly be a surprise to him.
How's he gonna top that?
There's the boat. Wakefield's probably keeping himself with the ticks. Whatever I do to him, it will be a mercy compared to what Lizzie has in mind.
Wakefield sealed himself in the cargo hold of the Undine. Smuggling ships like this.
You ever get that creepy feeling of being watched?
Surprising me, Dowd. Not long ago, I watched you kill an empress and steal her child for coin. For a man like that, you went through Coldridge Prison with an awfully soft touch. I wonder, are you hoping it will change the way things work out? Maybe. Maybe not. The song's almost over. And when the music stops, we all fall down.
Where'd you run off to?
This is the second time now. I see something, or someone, out of the corner of my eye. But when I turn, someone is watching us.
Time to signal Lizzie.
Lizzie Stride is assuming control of the Dead Eels now. She's ordered them to give you safe passage.
Your friend Edgar Wakefield sent me up to be taken by the City Watch, and you followed him. Took his orders. But you know what? I forgive you. All of you. I'm filled with love. But the following people each owe me a finger. Logan, Douglas, Bang Bang, Ferris, Pig Face, the Bakers, and Annabelle.
Shit.
Phew! From you, Annabelle. Have a good night.
That piece of garbage, Edgar. I'm still living with his incompetence. He let the Hatters cripple the Undine.
Ship seems fine to me.
They took the engine coil. We're dead in the water.
What is it? Can we make a new one?
They don't make them anymore, not for an engine like the Undine's. We'll have to get it back.
The Geezer still leads the Hatter gang, right? I'll pay him a visit.
It won't be that easy. There's a snag.
Always is. What's this one?
The Gazer's about 100 years old by now. He's got it rigged so that if he dies, the whole place gets gassed. So they're real careful around him. Got him a nurse and everything. Maybe you can cut a deal for that engine coil. Turn on the charm. One of the Hatters gave me their door password in exchange for keeping the rest of his fingers. It's whalebone. I never got to use it on account of the gas. And being in jail.
Just be ready to move when I get back.
You left Wakefield alive?
You can decide what to do with him.
My mind is racing. Does he still have both eyes? I'm not saying don't kill the Geezer. Just don't be stupid about it. What I see Dowd do.
Don't make me take that away from you.
If you're looking for new recruits, themselves. No, do they even know what's happening to them? No.
something's up.
Quiet in the city. Almost like it used to be.
I'm almost out of bullets.
Don't look at me. Try Jerome's new apartment up there.
I heard he was a cheat. Let me just...
What's the password?
Whalebone.
Come in, Hatter.
Sir, the Hatters are using the textile machines to make shrouds for the plague dead.
Now we know why they took the engine coil.
The man who runs the Hatters is more cunning than he looks. He can flood this place with a toxic gas. In time, it'll eat through our air filters. You may have to make a deal.
Who just went through here?
The Empress did. She had Corvo Atano with her. They weren't wearing no clothes.
Keep your head.
Dowd. I'm looking for Lizzie Stride's missing engine coil. I'm giving you a chance to make a deal.
It's a good thing to take our matter.
Yes, sir. Very reasonable offer. Geezer here says you're in luck. We only need that engine coil because someone shut off the flow that turns our water wheel. I said men into the sewers to restore the flow, and not one of them came back. But what stopped them won't be a problem for the famous Dowd, will it? When the water flows, I'll give you the engine coil. Here's the key to the sewer entrance, and it's a pleasure to do business with you, Mr. Dowd. The Hatters will behave themselves, as long as you keep your end of the bargain, Dowd.
This guy never made it back. Wonder if he's still down.
I have to keep this position. He says to bring the bottle I came by.
Are you supposed to be scary?
Things are at each other's...
She's afraid of us. When the change comes, we'll only know her
dies.
That makes no sense. We'd be reduced to dancing under the moon with parlor tricks. You must be wrong.
Why else would she put us here, right in his path? I wish he'd hurry up and come already.
Thank you.
together, aren't you? It's not easy. Delilah's exceedingly bright. Her coven is rising, with her as the night star to guide them. Change is coming, and Delilah has a plan. But do you, Dowd? And I don't mean stealing an engine coil or slitting an old man's throat. You're charging upriver, and I do believe you'll make it. But what will you do with what you find there?
Don't make me take that away from you.
It's done. But I don't think you'll see your men again.
No survivors. Terror is over.
Caesar says a deal is a deal. The code is 408.
You should get where you're going, little man. Get off me, blowhard.
Cut this bastard up for that!
Let's get on with it, Brass. Help me look for him. Okay. Keep banging her.
Gotcha! Somebody give me a hand!
I'm touched.
No fighting. Wonder how long that'll last.
Don't make me take that away from you.
You
feel it's weird not fighting them.
More time for business. We need to start moving goods again.
But now what? If you're looking for new recruits, no thanks. You are an only source of danger. That's another one for me. Please, do the honors, Dowd. Fire up the engine from the bridge.
The Brigmores were an ancient family, bankrupted a generation ago. Since then, the manor has housed two street gangs, a smuggling ring, innumerable rats, and the Brigmore witches. I'd always left them alone, but now a painter named Delilah had taken up witchcraft and formed a coven. She was trying something. A ritual. But what kind? The outsider knows. I cannot abide a mystery.
I scouted, sir. They've locked the front, and I've seen evidence of snares. Also, maybe it's nothing, but I spotted several statues of the woman Delilah. I don't know what it means, but I thought it was worth mentioning.
It means trouble. Anything else?
They're getting in and out of the house somehow, but I haven't spotted it. Sorry, sir. Best I can do.
Good enough. I'll take it from here.
Thank you.
should...
I grow sick of assassin. The other sisters speak of him with a tiny shudder of awe in their hearts, like stupid schoolgirls.
Don't worry, love. The hounds will warn us, or the statues, and then we'll descend on him like a crows, and we'll be his. All of our people. patience and work will be rewarded. But what happened to Melina? Is she...
Don't worry. She made them pay first. Is the new sister settled in yet? Will she last, I wonder?
Please. I'm sick of hearing about it.
Thank you.
Delilah wants to use Emily to become Empress.
You have many talents, Dowd, and they've served you. Delilah's talents are quite different. She creates images, but she does more. She captures spirit. She insinuates her will into her subject, whatever it is. We're witnessing her masterpiece, and perhaps yours as well. I gave you Delilah's name, and you followed it to this moment. You see now what hangs in the balance. Emily's life, Delilah's ambition, an empire in the act of crumbling. In your long life, I've rarely seen you act with such consummate grace. I give my mark sparingly, and I don't play favorites. But I will watch this with unusual attention.
The Void? Time to see what you've really got to hide.
Jessamine called me, heir to the Empire of the Isles. I call out to you from the Void. I call you with ochre from Mori. Carmine
Artist Narcissist.
Sir Conan Lazurite. Viridian Vile. The tones of your flesh I tempered with Pandician chalk. The same loom spun the fabric of your dresses made this canvas. I made my brushes from the hairs of your own scalp. Emily, you cannot ignore me. My power is too deep, my reach too long. Touches canvas. Brush touches void. And now I see you, Emily Caldwell. I breathe your breath. I can feel what you do. Bright mornings in the pub. I feel the cold night air of the ruin where you sleep. And the stink of the river. Image strikes the eye. Eye touches the mind. Mind touches the world. You will love the Corvo Automata and your lost mother. For your caretaker, Callista, I feel your fear in the night. Your hunger to learn, to become someone important. My hunger too. My fear. You are becoming mine. We are nearly finished. Close your eyes, Emily. Sleep forever. Feel the void open beneath you. Make room for me. Give in to me, Emily. Give in to me now! Paint flows. Blood flows. Life goes. Out with the old, in with the new. You've lived in his bones long enough, sweet young girl. Finished. It is complete. I am... What? What's happening? This is all wrong! What am I becoming? Outsider blood! Is this some trick? Go!
No one will ever know exactly what it took to save Emily Caldwin from a living death as Delilah's puppet. No one except the outsider, who watches everything and thinks his own dark thoughts and speaks to few in any generation. I've learned that our choices always matter. To someone. Somewhere. And sooner or later, in ways we can't always fathom, the consequences come back to us. I came from Cirkonos to Dunwall as a boy. Made my living as a killer. One of the few who've heard the Outsider's voice. I murdered an Empress. But saved her daughter. Who will one day rule the Empire. Those were my choices. I'm ready for what comes.
You make an eloquent plea for a man with innocent blood on his hands. It's a shame Corvo doesn't know the real story, isn't it? How in these last days you passed through Coldridge Prison like a shadow, dared the tangles of Dunwall's underworld, and walked out unscathed, outwitted one of the greatest witches in a generation, all with consummate care and skill. How you saved Emily Caldwin, daughter of the Empress, first of her name, and no one will ever know. But how does it end for Dowd, the hired killer, the murderer, the savior of the Empire? It's up to Corvo now.